नमस्कृत महाकाय सूर्यकोटिशंकर निर्विघ्न कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्यु सर्वदा सरस्वती नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारंभं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा वागर्थाय संपृक्तो वागर्थ प्रतिपत्ते जगतः पितरो वंदे पार्वती परमेश्वरो येनाक्षर समाम्नायमधिगम्य महेश्वरात् कृत्स्नं व्याकरणं प्रोक्तं तस्मै पाणिनेह नमः वाक्यकारं वररुचिं भाष्यकारं पतञ्जलिं पाणिनिं सूत्रकारं च प्रणतोऽस्मि मुनित्रयं धातुर्ब्रह्मैव संप्रोक्तो जीव आख्यातमुच्यते प्रकृतिकृत्स्वबन्तादिर्धातुब्रह्मात्मने नमः। शुक्लां ब्रह्मविचारसार परमामाद्यां जगद्व्यापिनीं वीणापुस्तकधारिणीम् अभयदाञ्जाढ्यान्धकारापहाम् हस्ते स्फाटिकमालिकां विदधतीं पद्मासने संस्थितां वन्देतां परमेश्वरीं भगवतीं बुद्धिप्रदां शारदां नत्वा सरस्वतीं देवीं शुद्धां गुण्यां करोम्यहं पाणिनीयप्रवेशाय लघुसिद्धान्तकौमुदी। टुडेज सूत्रास आर लिटिल ट्रिकी मोर देन they are usually, so please try and play little more attention today and I'll see if I can make some sense. I am a little sleepy as well. So where are we? Kati. So kati, how many in plural? So ikaranta pullinga shabda, but it is in the sense of plural only. So now kati plus jas, what happens? Shadbhyo look. So shat, shat is what we saw, the sanya. So sankhya also, if you look at where we landed here, so bahu gana vatu dati sankhya. So dati anta shabda gets the sanya. Sanya sutram as sankhya, sanya as sankhya. So kati is what? Kati is dati anta, therefore it is sankhya. नेक्स्ट वॉट डती च डतियंत शब्द डती च वॉट षट संख्या सो इट ऑल्सो गेट्स वॉट षट एज संज्ञा सो संख्या इज वन नेम एंड षट इज अनदर नेम एज वेल नाउ षड्भ्यो लुक वॉज कवर्ड एज टू वॉट देर जशसो हो जस एंड शस विल बी इलाइडेड वेन दे फॉलो अ षड संज्ञक अंग and then pratyasya luk ityadi, all that we saw. Now what happens when kati? So when you have this kati plus jasso, jasso so ho shadvyo luk, so shadvyo luk, shat is the sanya for dati anta kati shabda, and then shadvyo luk will cause luk of the jas pratya, and then you will have kati in bahuvachana as rupa siddhi. Pratyay lope pratyay lakshanam will not apply now by nalumatangasya, because look is lu, lum, so lumat, lumat anga, so lumatangasya, when the look has taken place it is lu, and therefore lumat will not retain the pratyalope pratyalakshana, so pratyalakshana will not remain, and then kati twice in bahuvachana you will get kati, kati, kati bihi, kati bhiha, kati naam katishu. Then yushmadasmad shatsanyakaha trishu sarupaha. Yushmadasmad shatsanyaka shabdadhar what? Panchan, shash, saptan, ashtan, navan, dashan and dati ending words. These shatsanyaka shabdas decline in the same manners. In what? Trishu api lingeshu ekam rupam. So there is a single root for all the three genders, so kati will also decline, just like you and mean yushmad, you and asmad, I have no bheda in linga. Similarly kati also has no bheda in linga in declensions. So that is the kati shabda. Now what? Tri shabda, ikaranta tri shabda, tri shabda nityam bahuvachanantaha. Tri shabda is always in plural because three is bahuvachana. So what happens here? So trayaha, trayaha, trin, tribhi, tribhya, त्रिभ्या एंड देन त्रयाणाम त्रिशु. सो दिस त्रयाणाम, हाउ डू यू गेट दिस त्रयाणाम? देर इज ओनली वन सूत्र यू नीड एडिशनली टू डिक्लाइन थ्री इकारांत पुल्लिंग शब्द. सो देर त्रय त्रीन त्रिभी त्रिभ्य त्रिभ्य देर इज नो इश्यू. दि फर्स्ट फाइव वी डोंट हैव एन इश्यू इंक्लूडिंग संबोधन फर्स्ट फाइव देन एंड पंचमी ऑल्सो. सो फर्स्ट फाइव एंड संबोधन देन षष्ठी बहुवचन वेन यू वॉन्ट टू गेट देन वॉट विल हैपन देर त्रेस्त्रय. द सूत्र इज त्रेस्त्रय. थ्री विल बी रीप्लेस बाय त्रय वेन आमी आमी प्रत्यय परे. वेन आम बहुवचन प्रत्यय फॉलोज देन वॉट विल हैपन थ्री देन थ्री विल बी रीप्लेस बाय त्रय एंड देन यू विल गॉट त्रय प्लस आम. सो वॉट हैपन्स देर थ्री थ्री प्लस आम थ्री विल बिकम त्रय. सो त्रय प्लस आम नाउ ह्रस्व नद्यापो नुट विल अप्लाय आद्यंत टकितो विल ब्रिंग दि नकार बिफोर दि आम षष्ठी बहुवचन प्रत्यय यू विल गेट नाम त्रय प्लस नाम देन नामी अंगस्य दीर्घ वेन नाम इज अ फॉर्म फॉलोइंग दि अंगा देन अंगा विल टेक दीर्घ एंड देर फोर त्रय विल बिकम त्रय त्रय प्लस नाम त्रय नाम देन अट्कुप वांग्नुम व्यवायपि रशाभ्याम नोण समान पदे विल गिव त्रयाणाम नत्वम टेक्स प्लेस. सो नकार बिकम्स नकार देन गौणत्वेपि प्रियत्रयाणाम वेन दि त्री शब्द इज गौण गौण इन समास गौण इन समास मीन्स इट इज उपसर्जन अप्रधान. सो जस्ट लाइक वी इन लोक मीनिंग when we do not have vyakarana adhara to using the sutras we don't have a adhara then in loka in vyakarana charcha what will you say we'll say samasa is what in what is pradhana we'll say uttara pada pradhana is tatpurusha anya pada pradhana is bahuri ityadi but sutra wise when you study samasas we'll see when we study samasas sutra wise there is a sanya called as upasarjana. So upasarjana means gauna meaning not pradhana and with upasarjana the samasas are explained in what kind of a samasa what becomes upasarjana ityadi. So what remains is that pradhana thereby in the loka there is a derivation as to usage of uttara pada pradhana is tatpurusha while purva pada is explained as upasarjana what becomes the purva pada in a samasa tatpurusha samasa there upasarjana is explained and thereby samasas are formed sutra wise but then upasarjana means non pradhana therefore gauna so that is a sanya used here gaunatvyapi priyatrayana. So the three shabda there is gauna even then it will this sutra will hold good and then you will get traya adesha in shashti bahuvachana and you get trayana priyatrayana kind of a form. Now dvi shabda means two. So it is nitya dvivachana there you'll get dvau dvau dvabhyam 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 dvayoho dvayoho there is no sambodhana there and nothing else is needed. So dvi also ikaranta declines in sarvadigana in the same manner as explained. Now you need another sutra for what tyadadinam ah vibhakto for the tyaditadi shabdas which are being dealt with here. Now what do you have with shabda? So dvi paryanta in tyadadi gana dvi is also there. So this is in passing it is explained. So this dvi when you decline dvi there what is said tyadadi nam ah vibhakto there is a vartika which says what dvi paryanta nam eva ishtihi dvi paryanta nam eva ishtihi means dvi paryanta nam एव इष्टि द्वि द्वि शब्द इज पार्ट ऑफ त्यदादिगण. सो त्यद तद यद एतद इदम अदस एक द्वि इत्यादि आर पार्ट ऑफ त्यदादिगण बट देन अदर्स आर नॉट लिस्टेड हियर बिकॉज द्वि पर्यंत ओनली अप टू द्वि अलोन व्हाट इष्टि द्वि पर्यंत नाम एव इष्टि दि त्यदादिगण इज डिजायर्ड फॉर दि ग्रुप विच कंटेन्स दिस ओनली अप टिल द्वि एंड देयर बाय दिस द्वि इकारांत शब्द occurs in this त्यदादि गण एंड our sutra says what त्यदादि नाम अह विभक्तो when a विभक्ति follows when a विभक्ति प्रत्यय follows then what will happen त्यदादि गण here our interest is what द्वि द्वि is part of त्यदादि सो द्विपर्यंतानाम एव इष्टिहि त्यदादिगण इष्टिहि सो त्यदादिगण एंड्स विद दिस द्वि हियर एंड त्यदादिनाम अह षष्ठी बहुवचन त्यदानम अह इज आदेश विभक्तौ परे व्हेन विभक्ति फॉलोज देन अ इज ए आदेश फॉर त्यदादि मीनिंग फॉर द्वि अ इज आदेश व्हाट विल हैपन अलोंत्यस्य सो अलोंत्यस्य विल कॉज द्वि टू बिकम द्व इकार विल बी रिप्लेस्ड बाय अकार एंड यू विल गेट अ So we'll get dvi plus au and vibhaktau has been said because it's dvivachana only you will get au so this is what au prathama ekvachana and out also will give you that out will also give you au only so dvi plus au since au is vibhakti sanyaka pratyaya when it follows dvi which is tyadadi gana antargata tyadadi naam dvi will get अ आदेश इकार विल बी रिप्लेस बाय अकार एंड यू गेट द्व द्व प्लस औ वॉट विल हैपन प्रथम पूर्वसमरण इज प्राप्त बट निगेटेड बाय नादिचि सो नादिचि एंड देयर बाय वृद्धि विल टेक प्लेस ऑल्दो प्रथम पूर्वसमरण वुड हैव गॉट गिवन यू अ सिंगल पूर्व आदेश फॉर बोथ अ एंड औ हियर वॉट विल हैपन यू विल गेट वृद्धि एचि औ इज एच So H will be the when H follows O follows then what will happen vriddhi so puro parayoho ekadesha akara dva ek akara and O H both are together replaced by vriddhi O is the adesha this is the roopa siddhi prathama bahu dvivachana and dvitiya dvivachana then dvabhyam 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 dvayoho All are vibhaktis. What are following? Sup vibhaktis, pratyas. Therefore, all will cause dvi to become dva. So, what do you have here in the roop? The roopa in the forms you get dvau dvau. There is no dvi form. Ikara form is not heard. Dvau dvau dvabhyam 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 dvayoho dvayoho. That is dvi. So, ikara anta is over. Now, ikara anta is taken. Dirgha. ई कार अंत पुल्लिंग शब्द अगेन रेरिटी पपी व्हाट इज पपी पाति लोकमिति पपी ही सूर्य सूर्य इज कॉल्ड एज पपी बिकॉज ही प्रोटेक्ट्स द वर्ल्ड सो पारक्षणे प्लस ई सम उणादि प्रत्यय इज एडेड बाय उणादि सूत्र यापो हो क्विद्वे च ई ही सो ई प्रत्यय इज एडेड एंड देन व्हाट डू यू गेट उणादयो बहुलम Thereby, Krutsanya is prapta and Krutadita samasascha will give you papi. So, yapoho quid dvecha, this e pratyaya parakshane will also cause what? E pratyaya will cause dvitvam. So, dvecha. Dvecha means pa will become papa and e. Then what? Abhyasakarya, dvitvam. As soon as dvitvam takes place, we have to look for abhyasakarya just like in sanadi dhatu derivation. Or sanadyanta, san pratyaya if you add sanadi pratyayas when you add to derive a dhatu, you have to follow abhyasakarya or in the derivation of the third gana dhatu, jyotyadi gana dhatu, dvitvam takes place. Similarly, this unadi pratyayi here, what do you have dvitvam and after dvitvam, you have to look for abhyasakarya in the seventh chapter, hraswaha. So what will happen? Abhyasasya hraswa, purva abhyasa, purva ubhaya abhyastam. Both get papa this and this together will get the sanyas abhyasta but both are abhyasta but purva abhyasa this fellow will be called as abhyasa first one abhyasa is only the first one this one and then hraswa abhyasa se hraswa so pa will become pa then papa plus e what will ato lopa iti cha will cause lopa of the akaranta dhatu Or when idagama follows also, anurti is there, all you know, I think ardhadhatuka, pratyaya should be ardhadhatuka ityadi. So there what will happen? Akara will take lopa of the dhatu here. So then pa, then pa has become pakara. So papa and e, papi. So you'll get papi. So this is krutthadita samasashtya will give you because it is what? Unadi pratyanta shabda. उणादीज उणादयो बहुलम विल गिव कृत्संज्ञा कृत प्रत्यय कंसिडर्ड उणादि प्रत्ययज आर कंसिडर्ड कृत प्रत्यय देर फोर कृदंत शब्द इज पपी इज कृदंत शब्द एंड यूल गेट कृतद्वित समासाश्च प्रातिपदिकम इट विल बिकम प्रातिपदिक देन यू अप्लाई सु इत्यादि एंड देन रुत्व विसर्ग ससोजुषोरु खरवसानयोर विसर्जने यूल गिव पपीहि पपीर देन पपीहि पपिस पपीर पपीहि सो दैट इज द रूप सिद्धि फॉर पपीहि देन प्रथमा एंड द्वितीय द्विवचन व्हाट यू गेट पपी प्लस औ ऑल दिस यू नो सो जस ज्ञा प्रातिपदिकात् प्रत्यय परश्च ऑल दैट विल गिव यू औ प्रत्यय इन द्वेकयोर द्विवचने एकवचने एकवचन ऑल्सो इज डन एंड नाउ औ इज द्विवचन सेम सूत्र इज यूज एंड देन अगेन प्रथमयोः पूर्वसवर्ण इज प्राप्त बट निगेटेड बाय दीर्घाज्यसि च what happens here you will get papyau ikoyanachi will give you papyau prathaya purva savarna will have given you e plus o both will have been replaced by purva savarna ikara but dirghajasi cha will replace dirgha e is followed by ich So what will happen? Ichi is also there. Thereby, e. Ich is a pratyahara which includes au. Therefore, what will happen? The purva savarna, prathamayo purva savarna, although prapta is negated, and then iko yanachi comes back, and then you will get papyau. Yakara is the adesha there. Papyau. Papi plus jas again. Prathamayo purva savarna dirghajasi ichi. पप्यः इको एणचि विल अप्लाई एंड देन ऋत्व विसर्ग विल गिव यू ससोजुषो रू ऋत्वम पप्यस विल बिकम पप्यर एंड देन खरवसान विसर्जनीय विल गिव पप्यः देन संबोधन हे पपीहि सिंस इट इज नॉट ह्रस्व एंडिंग देर इज नो चेंज इन संबुद्धि ह्रस्वस्य गुणः दैट वी सॉ इन इकार एंडिंग हरि शब्द becomes he hare ekara is guna of ikara in sambuddhi he hare but ikara ending is not hrasva ending therefore hrasvasya gunaha will not take place in sambuddhi meaning sambodhana prathama and will at the same prathama ekvachana form which is papihi so papihi also and then sambodhana he papihi then continuing papim पपीन पप्या पपीभ्या पपीभि पप्ये पपीभ्या पप्यः ट्वाइस पप्यः एंड पपीभ्या आल्सो ट्वाइस पपीभ्या थ्राइस देन पप्योः षष्ठी एंड सप्तमी द्विवचन देन दिस पप्य पपीभ्याम इज कवर्ड पपीभि पपीभ्याम एटसेट्रा इज कवर्ड बट व्हाट अबाउट द षष्ठी बहुवचन सो ही सेज दीर्घत्वात् न नुट पप्याम सो बिकॉज ऑफ दीर्घ व्हाट विल हैपन देर इज नो नुडागम एंड देन पपी प्लस आम विल इनवोक इको यणची एंड देर विल बी जस्ट पप्याम काइंड ऑफ अ फॉर्म देर इज नो नुडागम लाइक हरीनाम यू वोंट गेट हरीनाम यू विल गेट पपी प्लस आम एज पप्याम देर विल बी संधि बिकॉज आम डज नॉट बिकम नाम न्यौ तु सवर्ण दीर्घ पपी सो व्हाट विल हैपन in this is a very difficult form to see papi plus ni what will happen nyau tu akasavarne dirgha yakara is it here yakara goes away ikara is the content so this ikara papi plus ikara what will happen e plus e akasavarne dirgha this is saptami ekvachana papi sounds like prathama ekvachana so you have to be a little careful with the ikaraanta shabda Although it is very rare, whenever we come across it, papi, if you see, then something, if the memory is working, something should strike, and then we should consider it as, oh, not first case singular, seventh case singular. Then papyoho papishu ityadi, with the sutras we have studied, nothing more there. Evam vata prami adayaha. So vata prami is somebody who assess this for weather forecast. He is going to measure the weather, so to say. So vatam pramimiti, vatam pramimite iti vata pramihi. So one who measures the wind, who is that? For weather forecast, literally you can take one who measures it. But then ashwaha runs against the wind. So some kind of a there is no literal vyutpatti meaning there. Rudi artha is ashwaha. So vata prami, vata plus am. So it's a upapada, tatpurusha samasa, vata plus pra and pra purvaka ma dhatu. And vatam pramiti, it will be, it's a karma to that dhatu. Therefore, second case singular am pratya. All these will go away. You will be left with what? Vata prami. Ato lopa iti cha. Before that, supodhatu pratipadikayo ho look. So the supratyas within a pratipadika will go away. Since it's an upapada tatpurusha, it will become a samasa and krutthadita samasas cha pratipadikam. Then within the pratipadika, supodhatu pratipadika, within a dhatu or a pratipadika, sup look takes place, sup will go away. You will get vata prami. Then what happens here? Vata prami evam. So what has been said? Evam vata prami adaya. So there will be similar forms like papi for vata prami. There is a difference for bahuri samasa here, bahushreyasi, or some other dhatu particularly. Now this is a complicated section I was mentioning. What you have to remember is that yan is one adesha which we know by eko yanachi. Very simple sutra. Sandhi sutra itself is applicable multiple times. We have seen papyo ityadi. Now this yan is sometimes negated by another sutra. Yan is negated, so instead of yakara as adesha, you may get iya as adesha. And yan will also give you vakara as adesha. For ikara, hari, shabda, you will see haryo ityadi. Multiple places. And in guru shabda, you will see vakara, yanadesha, guru oho ityadi. Sometimes instead of this yan, yakara for, so what is taking ikara, yakara, ikara is taking ikara or e. Ikara or e is taking yan adesha. Similarly, ukara or u is taking vakara adesha by yan sandhi ko yanchi. Sometimes what will happen is that this instead of yan, you will have yang. Yang or uvang adesha. What you see is ikara becomes ia and ukara becomes u. Not ia, e. Ia. Sorry. Ia. Ia and ua. So instead of yakara, you have ia, and instead of vakara, you have ua. So this is by one sutra which will be shown. What happens is that sometimes this eko yanachi, which is negated by another sutra, we'll see which sutra, you will get ia and ua adesha, yangu angau. That is further restricted, negated, meaning it is negated. So this may be negated, ia and ua may be negated, and then what happens is that this sutra will go back to yan. Sometimes instead of going back to yan, yan itself is mentioned as an adesha by another sutra. So yan is by one sutra, iyang uvang by, you get iyang uvang by another sutra, iyang uvangau. Iyang uvangau are the adeshas, and sometimes either you go back to the earlier yan, or there is a negation of this sutra by another sutra which ordains yan. And there may be a fourth also. So negation to this yan also, when yang uvav will come back. So sometimes yang uvav is negated and you go back to this yan, or there is yan itself ordained instead of yang uvav. So either you go back or you come to this sutra. Sometimes what happens is that this yan also, which is first yan is prapta iko yanachi, then yang uvang, one of these is prapta, then that is negated and by another yan sutra, that yan is further negated by another sutra, then what will happen? not force sutra, but there is a negation sutra. That negation can take it back to iyang uvam. So yan, which is prapta, was negated by iyang uvam, which is negated by another yan sutra, which is negated by another sutra, and then it takes you back to earlier iyang uvam. So this is the complication here. That section is a little complicated for this reason, and the rules are further complicated. The rules are based on what? The rules may be based on dhatu which has ekach or anekach. So there is a dhatu which should be ekach. So you should know dhatu, whether it is ekach or anekach, meaning has a single vowel or multiple vowels. And then further complication is what? Whether that dhatu anga, anga is dhatu, dhatu anga. Further what? It should, whether it should or should not have sanyoga. So there is a sanyoga in the dhatu or no sanyoga preceding something. So sanyoga or asanyoga. And all this is in what context? It is in the context of what? Dhatu anga which is having ivarna or uvarna. So all this is applicable in iva and uvarna. Further what is needed? So further another thing which should be known. So 1 2 3 4 ABC, and then again Roman 1 2 3. What else should be known? Whether there is a nadi sanya involved at all, and that is what? E or u. E or u is what? Plus u will lead to what? U. U striakhyo nadi. Then striakhya is there or not? All that will hold good. What are we looking at? We are looking at pullinga shabda. In pullinga shabda, why will there be strilinga? Oh, it can be there. Why? Because bahushreyasi kind of a word, shreyasi, bahushreyasi, there it sounds like feminine. And it is feminine. Shreyasi shabda is feminine. But bahushreyasi is not feminine. Bahushreyasi is a bahu vrihi samasa, samasanta shabda, not samasanta shabda, it is a bahuri samasa shabda which has a strilinga shabda as one of the padas. And some vartika says that strilinga shabda, if it is nadi sanyaka shabda. Why? Because yustriyakhyo nadi. Because yustriyakhyo nadi will give the nadi sanya to such a pada which in the samasa is feminine, but after the samasa derivation samasta pada it becomes pullinga. But how do you deal with that shreyasi shabda within? So there is some vartika which will say this nadi sanya which has been retained, which has been given to that shabda, although in the pullinga it is there, although upasarjanatva is there, still it will retain the nadi sanya. Because of what? Purvalinga. It has a purvalinga, that purvalinga will hold good for derivation purposes. Although after derivation the word that you are left with is pullinga, because anyapada is pullinga. So in that context you have to remember all this, and that's what makes it complicated. So with this hopefully it will become easier, and I'll try to speed through for recap. Bahuyaha Shreyasyaha yasya sa bahushreyasi. So bahushreyasi, this is saha is masculine, this fellow is also masculine, bahushreyasi, but this is a feminine shabda. Bhavyaha, bhavyaha shreyasyaha. Who is shreyasi? Many shreyasi. One who has many shreyasi is called as bahushreyasi. That person, man, is called as bahushreyasi, and shreyasi is feminine. So shreyasi can mean good things also, and can mean ladies also. So one who has many women is called as bahushreyasi, or one who has many good things also is called as bahushreyasi. So you can see shreyasi shabda stands for women also and good things also. So women are considered as good in culture, Indian culture. So anyway, bahu plus nish, what will happen? The derivation is shown here. Bahu plus nish pratyaya bahuadibhyascha nish triyam. So the strilinga pratyaya nish pratyaya is will give you jnanta pada, and thereby it will become pratipadika, bhavi. Eko yanachi will apply, bhavi, you will get shreyas shabda. Shreyas, how is it derived? Shreyas plus nip, again to convert it to strilinga, ugidashtya nip triyam. So you get a strilinga pratyag nip. instead of nih, you get nip here. Both are niyanta and nyap pratipadikat. What will happen? Sumaujas, amaujas, ityadi. Now, what will happen? That is to decline bahuvi or shreyasi individually. But we are declining a samasa which is bahu shreyasi. So how do you derive that? Anekam anya padarthe bahuri samasa. Anekam anya padarthe. In the sense of anya pada, what will happen? Aneka padas will come together and you will get bahuhi plus shreyasi. Two words have come together here. Bahuhi plus jas, shreyasi plus jas. Many are there. So, suaujas. Both are prathama bahuvachana. Then supodhatu pratipadiko look bahu shreyasi. And why bahu? Bahuvi becomes bahu because bahuvi in feminine and bahu in pullinga or napumsakalinga have the same sense. And I think I mentioned the last part. There is bhashita pumska. I don't know whether this part, I don't remember. But anyway, bhashita pumska is what? In the samasa, there will be Pumvat bhava, bhashika unsan, pumvat bhava, you can see, because the words bahu and bahuvi both have gender difference, but the meaning stands same. Bearing the gender difference, the meaning stands same many. For example, if you hear the word balaha or bala or what? Balakaha, balakaha versus balika. So this is feminine and this is masculine. Bala and balaka are masculine, bala and balika are feminine. But both are what? Both are chhatra, they are children. So whether it is a male child or a feminine child, a boy or a girl, you get the idea that it is a child. So the same meaning is prapta. Whether you call as balaha or balika, the gender difference is there, but it does not take away the fact that both are children. When you have that kind of an understanding with the form change, but the meaning does not change, they have this bhashika pumsto. Meaning, pumvat bhava, bhashika pumska, they are bhashika pumska shabda, and then there is pumvat bhava. So, bhashika pumska shabda, take pumvat bhava. I said pumvat, you can just say that. When such words are there, Striyaha Pumvat, Bhashika Pumskad Anu, Samanadikrane Striyam Apurani Priyadishu Uttarapade. All that we'll see when we see, when the Laghukara takes up, if and when he takes up the Sutra. Currently what? Balakaha or Bala in the Samasa will become Bala. They'll take Pumvat Bhava. Bala will also take Bala kind of a form. And Balika will take Balaka kind of form. Similarly, Bahuvi will take Bahu kind of a form, which is Pumvat Bhava for a feminine word also in the earlier Pada. In the earlier Pada, it will be in Samanadikarane. When Bahuvi and Shreyasi are in Samanadikarane, then only this Pumvat Bhava will take place. It will not be in the Samasa where, some other Samanadikarane is not there. So here bahuvi bahuvi plus shreyasi will become bahu shreyasi. So now you have bahu shreyasi. Then what will happen? Yes, o bahuri here neti vachyam hraswaha na iti vachyam. In some cases, generally what will happen, as soon as you make bahurihi, then pumvat bhav, this is standing for what? Anyapada is pullinga, then hraswa adesha is there. But yes, a bahuri he na iti vachyam, hraswaha na iti vachyam, there is a vartika which negates the hraswatva in such cases, and thereby this ikaranta, masculine ikaranta, bahu shreyasi shabda is derived. Now what will happen? It is shabda which is bahuri samasa pratipadika, and then you will get bahu shreyasi plus su nyap pratipadikat halnya abhyo dirgat sudisya pruktam hal lopaha, meaning lupyate, hal lupyate, then this supluk will take place, you will get lup. Suplup will take place, lopa will take place, and bahushreyasi is the prathama ekvachana form. What happens to au, prathama dvivachana and dvitiya dvivachana? There, dirghajyasi cha ikoyanachi. This will, dirghajyasi cha will negate what? Prathamayo purva savarna. Purva savarna is negated by dirghajyasi cha ichi. Ichi is also there. As anuruti, therefore ichi will negate the prathamayo purva savarna after a dirgha, ikara is dirgha, thereby you will get eco energy. So eco energy will give you bhushresyo. Then in jasthana what will happen? Dirgha jasicha, jas itself is there, no ichi is needed, jas is there, and eco energy will apply, it will negate prathama purva savarna, and then you will get eco energy, simple yan. Now what will happen in sambuddhi? In sambuddhi, nadi sanya is needed. Why? In nadi, sanyaka will decline differently in sambuddhi, sambuddhi meaning sambodhana prathama. So now that nadi sanya is needed, which is introduced by the lagukara, yus triakyo nadi. So what does it say? U means what? E and U. E and U samasa is what? U. In Dvivachana, Prathama Dvivachana, U, it will become U. Yadasandhi, simple Yadasandhi itself will be U. So U, Sthriyakhyo, which are Sthriyakhyo U, Nadi. Nadi is the Sanya. Sanya is given. Ekaranta. So U, Sthriyakhyo Nadi, they will get Nadi Sanya. And then Vartika, which says Prathama Linga Grahancha. Why do you bring this Nadi Sanya, which is Sthriyakhya? While we are declining Bahushreyasi, which is Pullinga Shabda. So Vartiya is brought by Lagukara. Lagukara says, yes, it is needed. Why? Nadi Sanya comes in for Strilinga Shabdas, but Prathama Linga Grahanancha. Prathama Linga Grahanancha for Nadi Sanya, original Linga has to be taken into consideration. What is the original Linga in Bahushreyasi, Shreyasi Shabda? Bahushreyasi, Shreyasi Anta. And Shreyasi Shabda was Strilinga earlier and it had Nadi Sanya. Therefore, Prathama Linga Grahanancha Nadi will retain, where Nadi Sanya will be retained. So, Purvam Stryakhyasya Upasarjanatve Api, even if it is Gauna, why Gauna Upasarjana? Because Bahuri is Anyapada Pradhana. Being Anyapada Pradhana, Shreyasi, Bahu as well as Shreyasi are what? They are Upasarjana, and being both padas in the Bahuri are Upasarjana, they are Gauna, and Gaunatve Upasarjanatve Api Najitvam Vaktavyam Ityartha. It should be called as Nadi. So now you have Bahushreyasi treated as Nadi by Vartika. Now Sambodhana, what will happen in Sambodhana? Another sutra is needed. See, this is unfortunately difficult to teach also. This table does not belong here. It should go after the sutras. I mean, if I go through these, these sutras are not covered. Ambartha Nadyor Hraswaha, An Nadyaha, these are all not covered sutras. If they are not covered, Nadi Sanya is just introduced. Why would the table be here? This table is actually out of place. This is my opinion. It is difficult to teach this using this book. I had rather prefer to teach it on the board, because this throws off the students as well as the teacher. When I am going through the flow, aprapta is already there on the screen. I have to go explain this and then come back. There is no point in going back and forth here. So we will skip all this, or don't go through these tables. If you want to refer to the table, it is better to put the table at the end. You can chant these. I prefer those in the end. So now this, all this is mentioned. What is this now? If you see this on the screen, how do I understand or explain this? Ambarthanadyor Harswa. It is explained in the next sutra. That sutra is to be taken before it is given in a table. So Ambarthanadyor Harswa. And I have this issue with the other books also. If you see the earlier three books also, when explaining any pratyaya or anything, pratyayityadi, what these books do, what Medhaji does is that she'll give which is the it letter. Which is the it is in the sequence, pratyaya is mentioned, one or whatever number. Then two it letter is, I prefer this. So two content is mentioned, content of the pratyaya. How do you know the content of pratyaya? What is the point of studying the sutras in Vyakrana if you already know the content of the pratyaya? Then what is the point of studying the it sanya prakaranam at all? This is my objection to it. Third, you land on the it. Why would you land on it after you know the content? In fact, you say lashakvat taddite it, upadeshe jannasika it, adir nitudavaha it, then tasyalopa. Then only you will know the content. So if you know the content of nul pratyaya as vu, and then you can go to your anako, then why will I see why whether it is a nit pratyaya or not? I'll not get that also. So sequence is, this is wrong sequence. It should go before you land on the content. You know the it letters, tasya lopaha, then only you know the content. Content cannot be known before. So this is like putting the cart before the horse. So whenever I teach this to all the students in tuitions also, I say please follow the sutras. If you want to study the sutras next, or the books themselves have the sutras also, even if you don't want to go to sutra proper, it is better to know through the sutras what is what is prapta, then only you land on the content. So you take away all that is packaging, and then you, if you already know the content, then there you, what is the point of opening the box? It is not the content you don't have. You have to open the box first, then only you know the package contents as to what you have received. Anyway, so that's an aside. Ambartha nadyor hraswaha sambuddho angayoho. Ambartha nadyor hraswaha. What happens? Hraswa is the adesha for the ambartha or the nadi sanyaka anga. So this nadi sanya ambartha meaning what? Those which have the meaning of, the words which have the meaning of mother. Very interesting. That is why you see in Hindi, Amba shabda itself is Ambarthaka, means mother, Amba, which has become Amma in the South Indian languages. We say Amma, Amma, what is Amma? Bakara has gone away in pronunciation, has become Makara. So Amba, had it been like Rama Akaranta, we know Rama shabda is He Rame. But what is the Sambodhan of Amba shabda? It is not Ambe. In Hindi, they'll say Ambe, Ambe Mata, all that is there, Ambe, Jagadambe, etc. But in Sanskritam, it is Amba. He Amba. It is not like He Rame, He Amba. So here you see Ambartha Nadi. Therefore, you hear it, Ambartha is not there. But what is there here? Nadi Sanya is there. Bahushreyasi is Nadi Sanyaka. Why? Because of Purva Linga Grahanancha. It will give you Nadi Sanya. So Bahushreyasi is Nadi Sanyaka. And therefore, in Sambuddhi, Sambodhana Prathama, what will happen? Sambuddho angayoho hraswa ambartha nadyo, which are ambartha or nadi sanyaka angas, they'll get hraswa adesha. Then hraswa means bahushreyasi ikara will become ikara, and you'll get bahushreyasi, he bahushreyasi. So this is what the sambodhana prathama form in sambuddhi looks like, bahushreyasi, he bahushreyasi. Next sutra is annadyaha niti angat. In nyakara it pratyaya sthanas, anga will take what? Anga will not take anything. And nadyaha, here it can be panchami ekvachana or shashti ekvachana. So what is it? It is shashti if it is shashti ekvachana, then what will happen? Then that will take adesha. What has to take adesha? Niti saptami ekvachana tells you that when nit pratyaya follows. If it is shashti ekvachana, then sthani is there, that will take adesha. Adesha will not go to nit pratyaya. But we want the adesha, which is what? Art nadya. Art is an agama, it is not adesha, agama. Ad agama should go to nit pratyaya, not to anga. Therefore this is what? Not shashti ekvachana, it is panchami ekvachana, feminine. So panchami ekvachana an art is art nadyaha. Nadyaha, we are looking at the nadi sanyaka shabda, and it is declared nadyaha. After the nadi sanyaka shabda, what will happen? Nit pratyaya, nyakara being it, those kind of pratyas will take adagama, and adyanto takito will apply. It will go to the beginning of the pratyaya. So a will be takara, isn't it? Halantyam it tasilopa, then a agama will go to the beginning of the pratyaya, which is agnit pratyaya. So now what will happen? Nit pratyaya, first nit pratyaya, chaturthi ekvachana. Here what will be bahushreyasi plus nye is a. So ad agama will go to the pratyaya a plus a, bahushreyasi plus a plus a. Whenever ad agama comes, what will happen? Next sutra is needed, therefore you cannot do further karya. So atascha achi vrittihi ekah puro parayo samhitayam. So what will happen? This ad agama and the pratyaya, which is a vowel, a is a vowel, chaturthi ekvachana. So being nit, ad agama has come in. And A is an ach, so art plus ach, art ascha achi. When ach follows art, adagama, then what will happen? Vriddhi, both of these. And just to दिस पंचमी एक वचन वाय सेड दिस हैज टू बी पंचमी एक वचन बिकॉज पंचमी निर्देशो बलियान सप्तमी एंड पंचमी बोथ आर देर षष्ठी इज नॉट देर देन पंचमी टेल्स यू दैट वॉट फॉलोज इज अ स्थानी सप्तमी टेल्स यू वॉट प्रिसीड्स इज अ स्थानी एंड इन बोथ आर प्राप्त पंचमी निर्देशो बलियान सो पंचमी टेल्स यू सप्तमी इज स्थानी वॉट इज इन सप्तमी एंड दैट हैपन्स टू बी नित प्रत्यय सो नित प्रत्यय इज स्थानी सिमिलरली हियर वॉट आन आटश्च वृत्तिः एकः पूर्वपरयो संहितायां सो आटः च पंचमी एक वचन इट इज सेइंग वॉट पंचमी एंड सप्तमी आच बट हियर एकः पूर्वपरयो आदेश हियर वी डोंट हैव एन इश्यू बिकॉज बोथ वॉट इज प्रिसीडिंग एंड फॉलोइंग बोथ आर रिप्लेस्ड बाय वृद्धि सो आ प्लस ए विल बिकम वृद्धि ऐकार सो वॉट विल हैपन हियर ऐकार नित प्रत्यय हैज टेकन आड़ आगम सॉरी आठ प्लस ए सो हियर वृद्धि बोथ विल बी रिप्लेस बाय वृद्धि लेटर ऐ एंड नाउ बहुश्रेयसी प्लस ऐ वॉट शुड यू डू इको यणची सो बहुश्रेयस्यै इको यणची देन वॉट बहुश्रेयस्याः इन पंचमी एंड षष्ठी एक वचन आण्नद्या विल अप्लाय निति अंगात आटश्च वृद्धि इको यणची सो विल गेट बहुश्रेयस्य ऑल दिस इज सेम फॉर दीज प्रत्यास दीज प्लेसेस ऑल्सो विभक्तिस देन बहुश्रेयसी प्लस ओस ऑल्सो वॉट इको यणची जस्ट apply yanasanti and you will get bahushreyasyo then bahushreyasi naam what will happen hraswa nadyapo nut since nadi sanya is there it is not hraswa anta so hraswa anta it is not but nadi sanya is there therefore after bahushreyasi which is holding the nadi sanya for shreyasi shabda although it is upasarjana what will happen nudagama will come in when an aam pratyaya follows aam will become naam and then after aam has become naam देन नामी अंगस्य दीर्घ बहुश्रेयसी वी हैज टू टेक दीर्घ बट पर्जन्यवत बहुश्रेयसी ईकार इज ऑलरेडी दीर्घ सो नथिंग विल अप्लाई सो दिस इज वॉट पर्जन्यवत पर्जन्यवत मीन्स इट विल रेन इवन इफ दि भूमि इज वेट देर ऑल्सो रेन विल वेट इन दि भूमि विच इज ऑलरेडी वेट सो सिमिलरली यर ईकार इज ऑलरेडी देर दीर्घ विल कॉज दीर्घ ऑफ द दीर्घ मीनिंग नो चेंज रियली But we have to apply this. Why? Because if we lose the sutra order, then it is possible that next time we may not apply where it is needed. So when it is needed and still the when it is not needed because the karya is already attained, still we have to apply parjanyavat so that one for the accuracy and second that we'll know when it is needed, then also we'll recall. Bahushreyasi naam. Then what will happen is saptami. Niram nadyam nibhyah. So ni pratyaya is replaced by am by the next sutra. See, this is the problem. If I have studied it, then I'll say it is covered. It is not covered. In the recap, it is not covered. So here is replaced by am by the next sutra. Sutra is not given, but the karya is already applied. Not a good way to write a book. So niram nadyam nibhyah angebhyah. This sutra has to apply it before you give this. You cannot use it because this sutra is already applied. It should go to the after the sutra. This is an example to the sutra. So what you should say is that bahushreyasi plus ni you can do. Why? Because you have nyap pratipadikat, suo ujas ityadi, saptami ekvachana vibhakti sanya, all that is prapta. You can derive till here and then you can say aam also. Aam is not Shashti Ekvachana, the Shashti Bahuvachana, Saptami Ekvachana, this cannot be done. This can be done. You can derive this step, you cannot derive this step because you do not have Sutra yet. So now Laghukara leaves it. So if you follow a printed Laghu book, you will see Gita Prasityadi, Neram, Nadyam, Nibhyaha, Angebhyaha, this will come before the form. Otherwise, there is no point to introducing the sutra if you already know aam is the replacement for ni. So, what I said is saptami ekvachana, pratya. This pratya is saptami ekvachana. So, this saptami ekvachana pratya, e, which is content is e by nyakara going away. Lashakvatajite, tasyalopaha. Aam is the replacement for this ikara when it follows what? Nadi, aap or ni. Nye he. Nye he षष्टी एक वचन ऑफ सेवन वन नी नी प्रत्यय ने हे इट विल बिकम ने हे वॉट आप नदी एंड आम आप एंड वॉट नी सॉरी ने हे आम आम इज द आदेश हियर नॉट आप इज लेटर नदी आप नीभ्य सो देर आर टू आप्स हियर वन इज वॉट हियर दिस आम नॉट आप आम फर्स्ट इज आम इज हियर दिस इज आम फर्स्ट केस सिंगुलर नेहे इज सो पदच्छेद नेहे आम देन नदी आप एंड नी आर इन समास नदी आप नीभ्य पंचमी बहुवचन आफ्टर अ नदी शब्द नदी अंत शब्द आबंत शब्द नी अंत शब्द दैट इज व्हाट अंग अंगेभ्य आफ्टर दि अंग विच इज एंडिंग विथ नदी आप और नी इट्सेल्फ कैन बी नदी ऑल्सो बट कैन बी एंडिंग विथ बिकॉज तदंत विधि कैन अप्लाई अंगेभ्य एंड आम नद्याम नीभ्य आर इन सामानाधिकरण्यम विशेषण विशेष भाव सो वॉट विल हैपन इज दैट नी विल बिकॉज पंचमी इज देर एंड षष्टी इट्सेल्फ इज देर देर इज अ षष्टी सो नी विल टेक आम आम आदेश सो सेवेंथ केस सिंगुलर ऑल्सो विल गेट आम एंड यू विल गेट बहुश्रेयस्याम दैट्स हाउ यू गेट रम्याम ऑल्सो रमायाम सॉरी नॉट रम्याम रमायाम शेषम पपीवत एंड देन दिस बहुश्रेयसी विल डिक्लाइन लाइक पपी नो अदर सूत्र इज नीडेड इन द अदर फॉर्म्स सो नाउ यू सी द टेबल दिस बहुश्रेय व्हाट इज मार्क्ड इन बोल्ड इज अ डिफरेंस फ्रॉम द पपी शब्द ओके टू मच ऑफ एफर्ट बट वेरी लेस गेन बाय लर्निंग पपी बहुश्रेयस इत्यादि वॉट हैपन्स नाउ लक्ष्मी शब्द इज टेकन लक्ष्मी शब्द इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम ईकार एंडिंग बट वॉट लक्ष्मी लक्ष्मी इज स्त्रीलिंग बट वी वॉन्ट अ पुल्लिंग अतिलक्ष्मी लक्ष्मी अतिक्रांत इति अतिलक्ष्मी समास अव्ययी भाव समास सो अतिलक्ष्मी यू गेट अतिलक्ष्मी इट्स अ नित्य लक्ष्मी इज नित्य स्त्रीलिंग बट अतिलक्ष्मी इज वॉट प्रथम लिंग ग्रहण च विल गिव यू ऑल दो अतिलक्ष्मी इज अ मैस्कुलिन वर्ड स्टिल वॉट प्रथम लिंग ग्रहण च वार्तिका विल गिव नदी संज्ञा सो अतिलक्ष्मी विल ऑल्सो हैव नदी संज्ञा एंड देन वॉट विल हैपन here yeah so unadi sutra lakshyer mutcha so laksh plus e will give you mudagama also and you will get lakshmi shabda this lakshmi shabda what happens here since it is having nadi sanya therefore ati lakshmi shabda which is having nadi sanya will decline like nadi sanya word lakshmi lakshmi hi visarga so this we'll see in in this thing also in strilinga we'll see more now the next shabda is taken by laghukara is pradihi what is this pradihi it is it needs a gati sanya which will be introduced now so prakrushtam dhyayati iti pradihi this is an upapada tatpurusha prakrushtam dhyayati iti pradihi meaning what it means that this prakrushta and dhi there is a kriya yoga dhi धी ध्यय नॉट धी नॉट ध्यय धातु ध्यय चिंतायाम सो ध्यय चिंतायाम वेयर बाय यू गेट दी वर्ड ध्यान सो ध्यान वर्ड इज फ्रॉम द सेम वर्ड सो इट इज हैज ध्यान मीन्स वी से मेडिटेशन बट इट कैन मीन इन चिंता अर्थ ऑल्सो टू कॉन्टेम्पलेट सो कॉन्टेम्पलेशन इज ऑल्सो ध्यान एंड समाधि लीडिंग टू समाधि मेडिटेशन दैट ध्यान इज ऑल्सो ध्यान ध्यान कैन मीन बोथ देयरफॉर निधिध्यासन इज ऑल्सो टू वेज In orthodoxy, Nididhyasana can be considered as Samadhi, that yoga leading to Samadhi, that Dhyana also is the meaning of Nididhyasana. And one who has no interest in Samadhi, no, and positively says that I don't want Samadhi. For such people, you can take Dhyay Chintana and say contemplation. You can keep on doing Manana and that Manana itself will become Nididhyasana by serious chinta you become more and more serious there will be nididhyasana meaning it will become an abhyasa repetition nididhyasana is by abhyasa there is abhyasa karya there because it's a sananta dhatu ni purvaka sananta dhatu dhyasa so nididhyasa it will become didhyasa is the dhatu after san pratyay is added to dhyay okay anyway that's an aside to explain the dhyay chintayam dhatu what will happen आदे च उपदेशी अशीति सो आदेच उपदेशेशिति उपदेश अशिति व्हेन अशित प्रत्यय फॉलोज इन एन उपदेश आत एच एच व्हाट विल हैपन दिस आकार आत आत इज तपरकर्ण टेल्स यू इट इज आकार सो आकार इज द आदेश फॉर एच उपदेशे इन एन उपदेश एच मीन्स दिस एजंत धातु ऐ इज एच सो एजंत धातु विल टेक आकार एज आदेश आत इन एन उपदेश धातु इज एन उपदेश धातु पाठ सो इन धातु पाठ दिस ऐ एजंत ऐ अंत धातु झै विल टेक आत मीनिंग इट विल बिकम ध्या नाउ यू गेट प्र प्लस ध्या प्लस क्विप ध्यायते संप्रसारण च इत्यादि विल गिव यू सो देर संप्रसारण ऑल्सो एंड देन वॉट लेवल क्विप इज एडेड इट्स अ जीरो प्रत्यय कंटेंट इज जीरो बाय ककार बीइंग अ कित एंड पित प्रत्यय वकार अलोन रिमेन्स एंड एकाल प्रत्यय विल गेट अपृक्त संज्ञा एंड देन वेह अपृक्त विल अप्लाई लोपः वकार विच इज एन अपृक्त मीनिंग अ सिंगल लेटर प्रत्यय इन क्विप दैट विल बी इलाइडेड सो इट्स अ जीरो प्रत्यय What will happen? It gives a kartari pratyaya. Quip will give you here in this sense. It will give a kartari vyutpatti. So, what I said? Prakrishtam dhyayati meditates very well. In a prakrishta manner, he meditates. So, thereby pulling up pradihi, you get. So, vakara, all this vera pruktasi will take it away. Hala dirgha also. So, there is a dirgha. So, dhya. Has become what dhi samprasaran cha so here dhi plus a and vakara pratyaya so what has done here this akara will go away why akara will go away because after a samprasaran if it remains yakara has become akara there is a samprasarana for yakara to become akara not akara so samprasarana and then akara if it remains yakara has become what sorry akara has become not akara ikara yan so reverse of yan इकह यण ची इक बिकमिंग यण इज यण संधि एंड यण बिकमिंग इक इज व्हाट इज संप्रसारण दिस इज कॉल्ड व्हाट दिस इज संप्रसारण संप्रसारणम सो हियर यकार विल बिकम इकार वन ऑन वन यण इट इज एक्चुअली प्रोनाउंसिएशन बाय प्रोनाउंसिएशन स्थानेंतर तमः यकार विल बिकम इकार सो व्हाट हैज बिकम यकार ऑफ ध्या य हैज बिकम ई नाउ इफ आ दैट फॉलोज सो यकार हैज बिकम इकार एंड आ हैज बीन सेपरेटेड हियर सो दिस आ हैज बीन शोन आफ्टर द यकार देयर इज एन आ दैट यकार हैज बिकम इकार इफ यू लीव इट लाइक दैट व्हाट विल हैपन इकार एंड आकार संधि विल बी यण संधि अगेन सो इट विल गो बैक टू यकार सो देन ध्या विच हैज बिकम धी plus a will become dhya again. What is the point of doing samprasarana? Therefore, samprasarana cha pura rupam. After samprasarana pura rupam. Both put together, ikara and akara will be replaced by ikara. So these two will become what? Ikara. So both will become ikara, you will get pradhi. Now this va ve apruktasya, it will take away this fellow. But before that, halaha dirgaha. So there is a dirga, ikara, this dhi will become dhi. And this is how you get pradhi. So too much of effort to get pradhi and then what it is krittadita samasascha pratipadikam it is what it is a samasa therefore because of samasa it will get pratipadika sanya then nya pratipadika suojas so now we are under the su pradhi plus su what will happen halnyabhyo dirgha sudasya pruktam hal is not applicable although it is ekara ending what will happen here it says It does not end with ni. It is an ikara ending, so it is not hal ending, but it is not ab ending and it is not ni ending also. Why? Ikara is not come by ni pratyaya. It is not a strilinga word. This ikara has come by this sutra halaha dirgha ni, not ni. So ni pratyaya is not there. Therefore, pradhi is not ni anta, and since it is not ni anta, there will be no. दीर्घासुतिस्य अप्रुक्तम हल लोपहा दैट सुलोपा इज नॉट देयर एंड देयरफॉर रुत्त विसर्ग विल अप्लाई एंड यू विल गेट प्रधीहि सो प्रधीहि इज द फॉर्म इन प्रथमा एकवचन प्रधी प्लस औ नाउ इको यणचि इज प्राप्त नाउ कम्स द कॉम्प्लिकेशन सूत्रास आई विल जस्ट कवर अ कपल ऑफ दीज एंड देन विल स्टॉप अचिष्णु धातु भ्रुआ योर यंग वंगौ अंगस्य सो दिस इज सूत्र विच आई हैव ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन्ड एज टू इट इज एन अपवाद टू यंग वॉट इज द आदेश इयंग और उंग सो इयंग ञकार विल गो इय एंड उ सो ञकार सो इकार विल बी रिप्लेस बाय इय उकार विद उ And therefore, what yand will not be there? Instead of yand, what do you think in those who have studied ikara and the shabdas? What happens? Nadi will be what? Nadi. And then, oh, what will happen? Nadi, nadyau, nadyaha. There is a yand sandhi, nadi, nadyau, nadyaha, nadyau. Yand sandhi is clear there. But with dhi shabda, what happens? There is no, like mati shabda, etc. In mati also, nadivat and also harivat. So what will happen with dhi shabda, for example, buddhi? There, this dhi shabda, that dhi shabda, raswanta, what happens? It will not have like nadi kind of a form or mati kind of a form. That dhi shabda will have dhiya, dhiyau, not dhyau, but dhiyau. So what do you get? Sometimes you get the form as nadyau. Sometimes you get the form as what? Dhiyau. Why? So this ikara and aukara, when it goes into a sandhi and takes a yanadesha, you get yau kind of a form. And when it does not take this yanadesha due to sandhi, what happens is that it is negated with iyang vanga adesha, you get iya. So dhi ikara and aukara have not gotten what? They have not got the yana sandhi, but iyang adesha is there, therefore Iya plus au will become iyau. So nadyau or dhiyau, that is the difference between the two. And mati will also be like, mati will have a different kind of a form because it follows what like nadi. Or in fourth case onwards, there will be ghi sanya and then it will follow two forms. Fourth case singular, fifth case, sixth case and seventh case singulars. Four, five, six, seven singulars. Anyway, so if this idea is set, nadyau form or dhiyau form, how do you get? Because of this section. So what will happen? Nadi, but pradhi will become what? This pradhi, will it become pradhyau or pradhiyau? That is the question. So whether it will take this nadyau kind of a form or dhiyau kind of a form, this is the question. So what happens is that is replaced by what? Negated, yanasandhi is negated by achishnu dhatu bhuvam. Your yang vangu. What is your? Your is you. You we already know. So you plus what? Shashti dvivachana pratya. So ukara ending word vadhu shabda will become vadvoho. Similarly, you ending word will become what? Vyoho. Vyoho. Difficult to pronounce. Vyoho. Yang or vang. So ikara, this you is what? E or u. E plus u. So what I said is that ikara is replaced by what? By iya and ukara by ua. That is what it is saying, iyang and uang. And when will it take place? When an ajadi pratyaya follows. Ach pratyaya follows, ajadi pratyaya follows. And what should it follow? It should follow an anga, which is ivarna uvarna ending dhatu. Which has ivarna uvarna ending dhatu in the anga. Anga should be having an ending dhatu which is ending with ivarna uvarna, and anga should itself end with a dhatu, or it should be a shnu. Shnu is what? Shnu is swadi gana pratyaya. Swadi gana vikarna pratyaya. Vikarna pratyaya. So shnu ending anga, ivarna uvarna dhatu ending anga, or bhru. Bhru itself is a shabda, means eyebrows. So in these kind of scenarios, there is an iyang uvang pratyaya when followed by ajadi pratyaya. That's all it is. Complicated sutra, but meaning is very simple. For our purposes, what do you have? We'll skip all this. Aap plus, aap, we say aapnu. Aapnu plus anti, yand is negated, you get aapnu anti. So that's all it is. Bhru, bhru plus os will give you bhruvoho, not yand sandhi. That's all it is. Now our example is pradhi plus av. What happens? Iti prapte. So if it applies, Achishnu dhatu bhruvam, will it apply or not? Now here you see, shnu. Shnu it is not, bhru it is not. But dhatu, is dhi a dhatu? Dhi is definitely from a dhatu. So a dhatu followed by au, which is an ach. So achi is also satisfied. So achi is satisfied. Shnu dhatu bhruvam, after a dhatu, ach follows, that condition is satisfied. Yoho means e or u. in that e is satisfied, yo ho, e will take what, dhi e will take what, iyang adesha, iyang is prapta. So iyang is prapta now, so you would get what? You would expect pradyo kind of a form. But what happens? Another negation sutra which I was explaining. Er anekacho sanyoga purvasya angasya yan dhato achi. So now it says when ach follows, this condition has been met. We have seen dhato ho after dhatu, that is also dhato angasya. So shashti ekvachana, this dhatu, sorry, not panchami, shashti. So shashti ekvachana dhatu. So this what is e is of a dhatu, dhi, pradhi, in that e varna is of a dhatu followed by an ach pratyaya, because au prathama dvivachana dvitiya dvivachana au, yan is the adesha angasya, so dhatu anga is there and followed by an ach, ikara ivarna is there. Now it says ehe, ehe means e ivarna, e, I'll not say e or e, e varna, ehe, because e and e, both ikara, ikara, both will give you ehe. Ehe is what? E plus shashti ekvachana. So shashti ekvachana of e. So the dhatu pradhi, dhi is a dhatu which has e varna. So of a dhatu which has e, when an ach follows, this anga which has a dhatu which is e ending and has an ach au following, that time it says what? Ek anekachaha asanyoga purvasya. Is that dhatu having anekach or ekach? Does it have multiple vowels or single vowels? That is one question you have to raise. And another question you have to raise, whether it is sanyoga purva or asanyoga purva. So this is the second question, meaning whether there is a conjunct consonant preceding this anekach dhatu, whether it is having a conjunct consonant preceding ikara. Ikara of the dhatu. First it should be a ikara of a dhatu. That condition is met. It should be followed by ach. That is met because au is following. Anga dhatu is itself an anga. Or ending with an anga rather. Pradhi hi there. Ending with an anga. Now whether that ikara of the dhatu, e ending, pradhi, e ending, is it of a dhatu which has many vowels? Does not have many vowels. Anekach is not there. Dhi is a single vowel. But if you see anga, what about anga? Whether the anga contains multiple vowels? Yes, anga contains multiple vowels. Why? Pra dhi is there. A is there. And then dhi ikara is there. So anekach is there. Now is it that ikara, is it preceded by sanyoga or not? Is it sanyoga purva or asanyoga purva? It is asanyoga purva. There is no conjunct consonant preceding what? Ikara. Pra dhi hi. Pra is a... There, pra, akara is preceded by conjunct, but ikara is not preceded by conjunct. So dhakara alone is there, which is not a conjunct. Therefore what? Ehe anekacha asanyoga purvasya yan. So yan is another. So what we saw as to what? First iko yanchi at the beginning of the class. So just to revisit before closing, then the rest we will do in the next class. This important part will be covered. So first what? Yan. Iko yanchi is prapta. That is negated by iyang uvang. Then iyang uvang is negated by er anekacha. Iyang uvang by what? By the sutra that we saw. Dishnu bruvam. What is that? The sutra as to what? Our the sutra before, just before this sutra is what? Before ehe. Atishnu dhatu bruvam. So atishnu dhatu bruvam, your iyang uvango is replacing iko yanachi and bringing iyang adesha to this pradihi. Now this is also prapta, but it is negated by what? Not having a conjunct consonant preceding an anekach dhatu anga, the ikara ending of a dhatu which is not preceded by a conjunct consonant asanyoga purva. Therefore yan is brought back. Not brought back by Iko Yanichi Sutra, another yan is ordained. So this yan is different from Iko Yanichi. It is a yan all right, but it is not Iko Yanichi yan, it is different yan. So another yan is, which we saw in the third, in the introduction summary that we saw, overview that we saw. So what will happen? Pradhi plus O, yan, er anekacho asanyoga purvasya angasya yan. So anga will take yanadesha, ikara will be replaced by yakara, by sthane antartamah and then just varna mirana will give you pradhyau. So pradhyau is what? Prathama dvivachana, dvitiya dvivachana. That's all. Now further what? Pradhyah, pradhyam, pradhyau, pradhyah, pradhyi. All these where, and I'll skip this because finally we'll shesham papi vat. Other forms are what? Like papi. So thereby we can close the pradhi. Pradhi shabda is done as to nadhi sanya ityadi is prapt. You get the nadhi sanya. And now evam gramanihi. So with this we'll continue evam gramanihi in the next part.
ऋतावसाने नटराज राजो ननादडक्कान्नव पंचवारं उद्धर्तु कामः सनकादि सिद्धान् एतद्विमर्श शिवसूत्रजालम्।
नमस्ते, धन्यवाद।
नमस्ते, धन्यवाद।